The Google Pixel 6 almost slipped through our teardown lineup this year, but after the iPhone 13 display repair fiasco, which you can watch on our channel if you haven't already, we decided we had to take at least a little peek. You'll understand why in just a minute. To catch you up in case you missed the video last week, the iPhone 13 has a small chip on the back of the display that's paired with the Face ID hardware. And if you replace the display without also painstakingly moving that chip over to the new display, you will completely lose Face ID. After the internet made a big fuss about this, Apple quietly told The Verge they would be fixing the issue with a future software update. That pretty much confirms this was never a matter of security. It was either one more shot fired at independent repair, or just an accidental bug that they couldn't be bothered to fix before release. In stark contrast to Apple's slimy behavior, we have Google's Pixel 6 Pro. Thanks to Hugh Jeffries' teardown, which we'll link below, we know these phones have a similar software trigger that disables the fingerprint sensor if the display is replaced. But Google has done something right here. Let's open this up and see what's going on. To get started, I'll put this Pixel on our heat mat to soften the adhesive on the display. Like iPhones, Pixel phones usually open up on the display half of the sandwich, which means screen repairs are usually easy since they're the first component to come off. Once I'm past all the adhesive, the display can be fully removed by disconnecting this single cable here. And here's the first thing Google did right. Instead of just gluing this screen to the rest of the phone, they actually added a plastic frame around the edge of the display with little clips to hold it in place. This accomplishes two things. Number one, it adds a small layer of protection to the back of the OLED panel to save it from your pick during the opening process. And number two, it means if you can't or don't want to replace the adhesive on the screen after a repair, you don't have to. Just clip the screen back into place, and you're ready to go. Just watch out for water. On the back of the screen, you can also see the in-display fingerprint readers attached here, which is what we've seen on other devices. So speaking of fingerprint sensors, let's sidebar for a sec. Whenever biometric authentication is involved, it's obviously important for device makers to consider security. The less obvious thing that's also important to consider, though, is calibration. Calibration is what Apple is usually picky about when it comes to paired device components, and there is some actual reasoning there. Displays, cameras, fingerprint or face scanners, and many other parts go through a calibration during the manufacturing process. And swapping one of these parts after the fact can have an effect on the user experience, especially if the new part isn't up to spec. So what's the way around this? Well, if the original component can be calibrated at the factory, the new one can be calibrated too. And that's the second thing Google has done right here. Rather than force you to pay them to repair your phone and keep the fingerprint sensor working, they made an incredibly easy to use web tool that will recalibrate the sensor in your new display, as well as, I'm guessing, verify that it's a genuine part. And they had this ready to go at launch. No waiting around, crossing your fingers, hoping for a software update. Great job, Google. I just hope this tool sticks around longer than some of your other software endeavors. All right, back to the Pixel. I'm not going to go much deeper here because we've got some other exciting teardowns to get to, but I do want to check out this weird battery pull tab and look at their original chips. In my way are three graphite stickers, which might seem harmless, but if you're trying to remove them carefully to reuse them, they will quickly become your greatest enemy. Then some screws holding down this metal shield, and I can finally disconnect the battery. It seems like Google has included this clear plastic tab hugging the battery as a way to help remove it, but I can't for the life of me figure out what it's supposed to do. We thought maybe you could wiggle it back and forth to slice through the adhesive, but the plastic isn't strong enough to cut through it without a healthy dose of isopropyl alcohol. Ultimately, the plastic strip broke and we reverted to the good old suction cup method. This is the third thing that Google did right, or at least tried to do right. Lithium-ion batteries all age and eventually need to be replaced, so it's important to make that process easy to do. But this design needs a little bit of work, or maybe just a guide that would tell me how to use it. Alright, let's wrap this one up with some tasty chip ID. You can see here I've got a crisp bag of Google's original chips, thanks to user Tanuki Man from our community. I'll just open these up and see if I can't figure out what a few of them are. Okay, I think that might be the new Tensor processor, with maybe a hint of Micron memory. I hate to be a tease, but I'm actually going to leave the rest of these for some of my iFixit friends. But if you want to see more Pixel Silicon, let us know in the comments, and if enough people want it, we'll post something on our site. So the Pixel 6 Pro is sort of a mixed bag at the end of the day. I love the protected display, and I really love the free pairing software. But I feel that's something that we should expect, not give extra credit for. Battery removal procedure gets a C for effort, but it leaves a lot to be desired, at least without included instructions. Stay tuned to our channel because we've got some exciting teardowns coming up. We have AirPods and a fairly repairable phone, if you know what I mean.